Hi, in this class, I am going to tell about derivation of an R compensation resistor. Why we are going to take the R compensation resistor in the input bias current? Why? Because when we measure the output voltage V naught, the for the zero input, that means VA is equals to zero, the output also must be zero. For input is zero, the output must be zero. But due to the input bias current, the output voltage equals to 80 millivolts. Due to the input bias current IB minus and IB plus, the output voltage is 80 millivolts. This millivolts becomes a serious issue while measuring the output voltage. Why? Because of an input bias current in the input terminals, the output reads 80 millivolts. This becomes a serious issue. So we are going to use the very compensation resistor, that means R compensation resistor, for avoiding the millivolts output at the output voltage terminal. So here, for avoiding that 80 millivolts, that means reducing the gain, reducing the voltage value at the output, we are going to use the R compensation resistor to the non-inverting terminal of the input terminals of the output. So here, I am going to explain the derivation of an R compensation resistor. Here I am going to use the R compensation resistor. It is an R compensation resistor. Here the millivolts becomes a serious issue for measuring the output voltage. So here, for avoiding that millivolts output voltage, I am going to use the R compensation resistor. Here I am going to explain the R compensation resistor derivation in this class. Here we are going to use this circuit. In this circuit, I am add R compensation resistor. This is an resistor for avoiding the millivolts output reading. So RF is the feedback resistor. Here RF is the feedback resistor, R1 is the resistor to the inverting terminal of the op amp, V1 is the voltage across an inverting terminal, and V1 is the voltage across the non-inverting terminal. Here we are going to give the input, voltage input as 0, and I1 is the current flowing through this, and also IB minus from this node, the current flowing through this IB. Through inverting terminal is IB minus, and a current flowing through this non-inverting terminal is IB plus. Here IB plus and IB minus are the current flowing through this inverting terminal and to the non-inverting terminal, and V naught is an output. I2 is the current flowing through along this loop, and V2 is the voltage across a resistor R. So here R compensation is the resistor, compensation resistor. So here I am going to take this circuit and derive the concept of an R compensation resistor. For the derivation part, I am going to take this loop, this voltage, apply voltage KVL, that means apply here very easy simple derivation to this part. So here first of all take this loop V1 and voltage V0, V2 and V0. Here apply KVL along this loop, apply KVL law. So here we can get minus plus 2 minus, means we can get minus V1 here 0 volts. So also consider this 0 volts, nothing problem. without consider and with consider. And a plus minus to plus means by using KVL law we can get a plus V2 and a plus 2 minus it goes to from plus to minus. So minus V0 that is equals to 0. So here we want V0. We want V0. So taken out the V0 to the left hand side, V0 is equals to we can get V2 minus V1. This is taken as a first equation. We want V0 as an output. So we can consider V0 in the left side and taken right side remaining terms. V0 is equals to V2 minus V1. From the circuit, I apply the KVL at V0, V1 plus 0 volts minus V2 plus V2 minus V0 is equals to 0. So we can get V0 is equals to V2 minus V1. Simple. Apply KVL to this voltage terminal. Then we can get minus V1 plus 0 volts and plus V2 minus V0 is equals to 0. Simple. So we want output voltage. So here V0 is equals to V2 minus V1. Taken this as an first equation from the circuit. So here assume we have to consider some points. Have to assume some points from the circuit. That means here the current flowing through this inverting terminal and the current flowing through this non-inverting terminal are same. Assume, for example, we are going to assume IT minus is equals to IB plus. IB minus is equals to IB plus. This is taken as a second equation. Why? Because I am going to write IB minus is equals to IB plus means here IB minus is the current flowing through this inverting terminal is equals to the current flowing through this non-inverting terminal. That means the same currents are flowing along the inverting terminal onto the non-inverting terminal. So I am just assume that IB minus is equals to IB plus. For the simplification purpose, I am going to equalize the currents flowing through this inverting terminal and to the non-inverting terminal. So I can assume here and write here IB minus is equals to IB plus. So here I can erase this part for clear visible. So from here, from the circuit, we can have lot of equations like consider this is a node. For example, this is node A, here node A. Consider this is a node A. Now apply KCL law. Apply KCL law at node A. Consider this is a node A and entering current is equals to leaving current. So here to this node A, entering currents are I1 and I2. Simply the leaving currents are IB minus to this node. The entering currents are I1 and I2. Leaving currents are IB minus. Simply entering currents are I2 and also leaving currents are IB minus. So here the law tells that entering current is equals to leaving current. So I can write here IB minus is equals to I1 plus I2. simply we can get from the circuit from node A, entering current is equals to leaving current. So I1 is equals to I2. I1 plus I2 is equals to ID minus. Entering currents are I1 and I2. Leaving current is IB minus. So we can get IB minus is equals to I1 plus I2 as in third equation. So and also from the circuit, I'm going to write here. This is also another circuit. In next slide, this is a circuit. Same circuit. For the explanation, I am placing here. Same circuit. So here, from this circuit, we have lot of equations like this. I want final R compensation resistor derivation. So I am going to take the resistors values and the current values for the simplification process from the circuit. Whatever we want, we are going to take that equations first of all. So here, from the circuit, we are going to take I1 value and also I2 value. So from the circuit, I am going to take I1 is equals to and I2 is equals. So here I have I1 and I have I2 here. I1 and I2. So from I is equals to V by R. We already know V is equals to IR. So then we are going to write V is equals to IR. So I is equals to V by R. From these I is equals to V by R. So I1 here and the I2 here. So voltage here flowing through this resistor R1 is V1 and the resistor we are going to take here is R1. So here we can write from the I is equals to VR, I1 is equals to V1 by R1. This is taken as our fourth equation, and from this circuit, from this I2, I am going to write the I is equals to V by R. Here I is an I2 and V is an V2 by RF. Simply I2 is equals to V2 by RF. So I2 is equals to, we can get V2 by RF. Simply, very simple equations from this circuit. I am going to take very simple equations. I2 is equals to V2 by RF. I2 is equals to V2 by RF. This is taken as an fifth equation. I1 is equals to V1 by RF. R1. I2 is equals to V2 by RF. Very very simple equations I am writing. So we have I1, I2 and also V0 value and also IB minus is equals to IB plus and also IB minus is equals to I1 plus I2. So for example, I am assuming here I am going to take voltage input as 0 volts. Why? Because I am going to give the input. Input is an 0. That's why output becomes a 0. So that's why I am going to give the input as 0. Input voltage is 0. Then obviously we can get an output voltage as also 0. So here, for example, I am going to give voltage input as 0 volts. Voltage input as 0. I am mentioning here voltage input as 0 in the circuit. So here voltage input becomes 0 means then I can get voltage output also 0. If voltage input is 0, then I can get and voltage output also 0. Then obviously, from first equation, V0 is equals to V2 minus V1. From first equation, this is the first equation of V naught is equals to V2 minus V1. So, from first equation, we have V naught is equals to V2 minus V1. Then, put V naught is equals to 0 in first equation, we can get, what we can get? 0 is equals to V2 minus V1. I can substitute my 0 value in the first equation, then I can get 0 is equals to V2 minus V1. Then I have write like this, V2 is equals to V1. So I can get V2 here, V2 value as V1. V2 value as V1. Why? Because I am going to take a V input value 0, that output becomes obviously 0. So that's why from first equation V0 is equals to V2 minus V1. From V0 is equals to V2 minus V1, then I can put my V0 value in the first equation, then I can get 0 is equals to V2 minus V1 here. So V2 becomes as V1. Take to this left side and right side, so I can get an V2 is equals to V1. So it is taken as a sixth equation, very very simple terms. Okay. Then here V2 becomes V1. So from this fifth equation, this is also another circuit of an R compensation resistor, same circuit I am going to place here. Why? Because for explanation purpose I am going to place here the R compensation resistor, same circuit. Here put the V2 value is equals to V1 in fifth equation. What is the fifth equation? I2 is equals to V2 by RF. So here V2 as V1, so I2 is equals to here, there fifth equation V2, it is having V2. So here V1 by RF, this is taken as a seventh equation. Okay, in the place of an V2, I am going to write the V1 in the I2, that is an fifth equation. So, for the simplification purpose, we are going to consider these terms. Okay, here we have an I1 value and also I2 value. We have both I1 and I2. So, we are going to simplify the equations by using these third equation, which is an IB minus is equals to I1 plus I2. We have I1 term and also we have I2 term. So I am going to add those I1 term and the I2 term. For the simplification purpose, here I1 is in the form of an V1 by R1. So I am going to take also I2 in the form of an V1 and the RF. So that's why I am going to give voltage input 0, then output becomes 0, then we can get an V2 term in the terms of an V1. So for the simplification purpose I am going to take the letter. So from the third equation we have IB minus is equals to I1 plus I2. I am going to write these another time IB minus. If you don't need, no need to write here. For the explanation, I am writing here for the process. So IB minus is equals to I1 plus I2. So IB minus from 3 we have IB minus is equals to I1 plus I2. We have I1 value and also I2 value from substitute I1 and I2 in third equation. We have I1 values and I2 values. Substitute those I1 values and I2 values in the third equation, we can get I1 is V1 by R1. Here I1 is V1 by R1. So I am writing IB minus is equals to V1 by R1 plus I2 as V1 by V1 by RF. I2 is V1 by RF. So here, V1 is taken out for the simplification purpose. 1 by R1 plus 1 by RF. So, V1 is equals to 1 by R1 plus 1 by RF. That is equals to IB minus. From the first equation, we are known that IB minus is equals to IB plus. That means the current flowing through this inverting terminal is equals to current flowing through the non-inverting terminal. So IB minus is equals to IB plus. So here we can get an IB minus value. We have an IB minus value. So from one we are going to write like this. From one. We have IB minus is equals to IB plus. So I am going to substitute in the place of an IB minus. I can have an IB plus is equals to V1 of 1 by R1 plus 1 by RF. It is very clear that in the place of an IB minus, I am going to write the IB plus. Why? Because I am going to write the IB plus here. So from the circuit we have IB plus value. IB plus value. Why? Because in the place of an IB minus, and for the simplification purpose, I am going to take the IB plus. Why? Because from the circuit we are going to take the all compensation resistor. So that's why I am going to take the IB plus value. So we have current I is equals to V by R formula. So here I'm going to write the equation for the current in the terms of an R compensation. So we are going to take the IB plus value rather than IB minus value. Why? Because there is no R compensation resistor. Here only we have an R compensation resistor. So I'm going to take the IB plus value for the simplification of an R compensation resistor here. So I can write IB plus is equals to here V1 by R compensation. V1 by R compensation. Very simple. IB plus is equals to V1 by R compensation. So I can get from circuit I am going to write IB plus is equals to V1 by R compensation. IB plus is equals to R compensation. Why? Because I am going to take the R compensation. Finally, I want to derive the R compensation. So, I am going to take the IB plus rather than IB minus here. So, here we have an IB plus value. So, substitute this in this equation. The equation is 8th equation. This is taken as an 8th equation. Substitute IB plus value, IB plus in 8th equation we can get IB plus is V1 by R compensation. V1 by R compensation is equals to V1 of 1 by R1 plus 1 by RF. 1 by R1 plus 1 by RF. So simply we can get the value of an R compensation by using this. Here simply placing the IB plus value in the 8th equation. IB plus is equals to V1 by R compensation. So IB plus value substitute here. V1 by R compensation is equals to V1 of 1 by R1 plus 1 by RF. So simply cancel out this V1 and V1. We can get R compensation is equals to RF plus R1. This is RF by R1 into RF. R1 into RF. So, take an R compensation to the numerator and R compensation is equals to becomes R compensation becomes as R1 RF by R1 plus RF. We can get an R compensation derivation part or compensation output. Simply we can write R compensation as R1 is parallel to RF. Simply we can write like this. No need to write like this. We can use this formula. R compensation is equals to R1 RF by R1 plus RF. So here it is very simple to derive the R compensation. The derivation part of an R compensation is very simple. By using the R compensation, we can compensate the voltage in terms of an millivolts. Why? Because we are giving zero input to the input terminals of inverting and non-inverting terminal, but the presence of an output. But while measuring the output voltage V naught, the output measures in terms of an 80 millivolts. Considering the feedback resistance and also IC741 current, it uses IC741 input bias current, uses some current, that means like 80 millivolts, 80 volts like that. So that's why measuring the output voltage 80 millivolts, it is a serious issue. So we are going to use the R compensation resistor by measuring the output voltage. Why? Because here I am using R compensation resistor for the purpose of decreasing the output voltage, that means decreasing the output voltage at an output by measuring the output voltage from the input bias current. So it is a derivation part of an R compensation resistor. So here we can apply KVL law V naught. We can get an V naught value here, and we are going to assume IB minus is equals to IB plus. But also at a node A, we are applying the KCL law. From that, IB minus is equals to entering current is equals to leaving current. So IB minus is equals to I1 plus I2. And also we are going to take from this circuit I1 value is equals to V1 by R1 and I2 value is equals to V2 by RF. I am going to take the IT value in the terms of an V1. So for the simplification purpose, I am going to add the input 0. So I am going to give the input voltage as 0. So then output becomes obviously 0. Then from first equation, we can write V0 is equals to V2 minus V1. So V0 becomes 0, then V0 is 0. So then substitute this V0 value in first equation, then I can get 0 is equals to V2 minus V1. From these, I am going to write V2 value as V1. Then it is on sixth equation. So here I2 is V2 by RF. So in the V2 place, I am going to write V1 in the place of an V2 from the sixth equation. Then I can get I2 value V1 by RF. So I have equation from the circuit IB minus is equals to I1 plus I2. So I have an I1 value and I2 value. So I am going to substitute I1 value as V1 by R1 and I2 value as V1 by RF. So taken out the V1 as outside, and I can simplify this equation as 1 by R1 plus 1 by RF. So, in the place of an IB minus, I am going to take the IB plus. Why? Because both the currents flowing through inverting terminal and non-inverting terminals are same. So, in the place of an IB minus, I am going to write the IB plus. For the simplification of an compensation resistor, from this circuit, from the circuit, I am going to derive the IB plus. IB plus is equals to V1 by out compensation. So I am going to write in the place of an IB minus is equals to IB plus. So here IB plus I am going to write from the first equation. So IB plus is an V1 by R compensation, that is equals to V1 of 1 by R1 plus 1 by RF. So I am going to cancel the V1 and V1. So both are same. So I can get 1 by R compensation is equals to RF plus R1 by R1 RF. Then taken this to the numerator side, our compensation is equals to R1 RF by R1 plus RF. This is the derivation part of an R compensation resistor. By tomorrow's class, I am going to explain the input offset voltage. Thank you.